Like, he can see the floor. He can run an offense. He's got great passing ability. He's different from those two guys. I like him. RJ Barrett, I think he'll be a scorer in the NBA. Mm-hmm. I hope I'm wrong, but I see a volume scorer, volume shooter, mm-hmm. you know, puts up big numbers, maybe not on great teams. Hopefully I'm wrong about him and he becomes better than that. But I'm going with Zion as the best player of these three. I see everything that he has. Like, first of all, he's got the intangibles. You could see last night, he was so comfortable in the spotlight. Like, he was smooth. He was just like, you know, like he had been there his whole life.
LeBron style, though.
Mm. Well, he went with the white. I like that, too.
It's
like
cream.
Is it cream?
So he wasn't.
It is cream.
Was he mimicking
LeBron? Am I right? That is cream on white.
That's been a debate today.
Cream on white.
Technically, Skip, you are correct.
Okay.
But you know.
LeBron's was what? Bright white?
Bright white.
And a little baggier. White with a white tie.
Right.
This is a tuxedo shirt that he's wearing with an open collar. I don't think it's homage at all. Go ahead.
All right. Anyway, he's got the intangibles. He's got the work ethic, mm-hmm. right? He's got this infectious joy about him when he plays.
Never seen anything like it.
Right. Yep. Defensively. LeBron, who became a tremendous defender, wasn't defending like this even his first couple years mm-hmm. in the league. Like, he wants to defend. And then offensively, he can handle the basketball well enough. He's got pretty good court vision. People talk about his shot being broken. It's not broken. I mean, people talk about he can't shoot, but it's not broken. It's got a decent mm-hmm. Form. Mm-hmm. And look, he'll improve. He with his work ethic, he will work on his jump shot. Blake Griffin averaged less than 1 3-point attempt for his first 6 years in the league. He took 7 a game last year. And so he can improve his
three-point
shot.
What did I keep telling you when we were at ESPN about Blake Griffin at Oklahoma? He stayed 2 years. I watched every game he played. I never saw him make a shot over 3 feet at Oklahoma, and that's the God's truth. 3 feet.
Yep.
He had no shot.
Mm-hmm. And okay? he probably didn't work on it earlier.
You know what? He's a pretty good three-point shooter.
Pulling open.
Yeah. So Zion can become a good three-point shooter. He's got a quick first step. Today's NBA, the floor is so spread, he'll be able to get to the rim and finish over guys. We know they'll be running the break with Lonzo. But here's the thing people miss about Zion, and I think a lot of people that aren't sure about him, he's unique. He's different from the majority of today's young stars because the majority of today's young stars dominate the basketball. They grow up with the ball in their hands all the time. At Duke, he got 22-9 off the ball. Mm-hmm. RJ Barrett had the ball or Trey Jones had the ball. Mm-hmm. Like, he was off the ball. Yep. I love that because that'll make it easier to play with other guys. I think he'll be able to fit into a system. He won't have to dominate the system. And so I think that's what's throwing some people off. Like, oh, we're used to seeing, you know, the number one guy always have the ball and create for everybody else. He doesn't have to do that. That's almost like an old school guy. And I like that about him. So I think Zion's going to be the best guy.
I went with Ja because I like his game. I mean, I love all the guys' game. Everybody has something they can do really well. I agree with you. RJ Barrett can put the ball in the basket, but I just think it's going to take volume shots in order for him to do that at the level that the Knicks fans are. That's a shame. The Knicks, if you didn't know better, boy, you swear the Knicks had drafted like Jordan or somebody. Like, he was Spike Lee was in a tent. Spike Lee was hugging and taking. I'm like, come on, Spike.
This could be their best news of the summer.
This is what they reduced Spike Lee to. Getting RJ Barrett, and probably that's it. And he's excited about that. But when I look at Ja Morant, I love how he lets the game come to him. If he needs to score 20, I'll get to 20. You need 30, 35, I'll get you that too. But you might need 15 assists. The game comes to him. I'm not so sure RJ Barrett ever did that. Because it seems like when Zion started getting it going, he's like, oh, y'all talking about him too much. I hear you over there, Dickie V. I hear you over there, guys, talking about Zion. True. Let me get a couple of threes. Let me go to the basket and show you what I can do.
No, let me miss a couple of threes.
that too, Skip. For me, I'm looking at Zion. I'm looking at his shot chart. He made 79. Basically, he made 80% of his shots in the restricted area. Outside the restricted area, it was 37. Now, we know a guy, I know a guy that was supposed to, he's probably going to win the MVP because Chris Broussard voted for him. And Chris always, he's the, you know, godfather when it comes to this voting thing. He knows it. But the other team that won the title, they built a fort around the restricted area. They wouldn't let him in there. And every time he tried to come, Skip, you said they had Kawhi or Claw. You really didn't need no help, but he says, okay, just in case.
He had three help.
Then you had Big Mark Gasol, you had Serge Ibaka, you had Siakam sometimes. They just had this standing at attention.
You got shot blockers galore out there, three of them.
Like trying to get in the Buckingham Palace.
That is
guy
correct.
Was just standing out there at attention. Wouldn't let him in there.
That is correct.
Well, we're going to see if Zion got to develop a jump shot.
Okay. Right.
That set shot he be shooting from the three, that ain't going to fly. Because just like he threw that guy from Virginia in the stands, they'll be throwing that in the stands.
What big man shoots a jump shot from three? They all shoot seven.
Lot of them.
Oh.
Lot of them. AD.
Huh.
Lot of them.
He'll take it more than Giannis will. Mm. Like, he's not where Giannis or Ben Simmons. I mean, Ben Simmons is way worse.
Yeah.
So, he's not that bad.
And plus, Ja Morant is a freaky athlete. Mm. I mean, he is freakish. He's in that Russell Westbrook cloth. But he can shoot the ball better than Russ. Mm-hmm. Russ can only dream of shooting. He's a 50% from the floor guy. Russ is never shooting 50% from the floor.
Mm.
34% career from three-point line. This kid shot 36%, although the college line was a little shorter. And I don't want to get too hung up on the college three-point line because I know a guy shot 41% in college and barely can shoot 30% right now in the NBA. Mm. We ain't going to talk about the guy that's New Orleans right now. But you know what?
It's time to make clutch threes. He makes clutch threes.
Well, how about clutch free throws? Can he make those? But anyway, I'm going with
Let's see what he does in New Orleans next year.
I'm going to take Ja Morant. And plus, again, Skip, he's 285 at 18. What's he going to be at 25?
The New Orleans should already have him a nutritionist.
Mm.
Really? He'll get that baby fat, get a lot of that baby fat. Barkley. Barkley slimmed down a little when he got to the NBA.
He slimmed down to 270.
Barkley?
Yeah. So he better stay away from Commander's Palace eating shrimp and grits. Mm. Not what I heard he had.
That is true. I give you that. Shannon Sharp.
What?
Once again, you are barking up the wrong tree, or in this case, should I say sapling, because this is a sapling you're barking up. I have told you before, I love Ja's game when he has the ball in his hands. Love it. I told you after the Marquette game in the NCAAs, never seen anything like this. He is an ambidextrous passer. He's just as good left-handed as right-handed to the point. I watch him and I forget. Wait, is he left-handed? No, he's right-handed, but he plays left-handed just as well as right. Special stuff. I'm concerned about the shot because he has no jump shot at 6 feet two. And when you go up a level into the next league, as we saw happen to Trae Young, you start having issues because you have to start shooting it farther and farther out there because Trae Young shoots a set shot. He has no jump shot either. It's feet on the floor, set shot.
He got 49 against Chicago.
Okay.
Shooting that set shot.
But again, can you win with that?
Trae came on. Yeah.
I don't know. He also got a shot blocked more than any point guard. He just got blocked. The Spurs blocked 8 shots one night at Atlanta. They blocked him 8 times in one game.
Well, I mean, come on, Skip.
Okay. I'm just saying. If that's part of your repertoire, feet on the floor can be blocked at the next level. He doesn't have a big rise up and jump shot like Steph has or any Clay or any of those guys. So the other problem with Ja Morant is in the games I watched, he played little to no defense. It's an afterthought to him. Meanwhile, the other guy we're talking about, Zion is going to win, to me, multiple Defensive Player of the Year awards in the NBA. That's how dominating he is on defense. I haven't started on the offense, just on that alone. I'm taking Zion just on the defensive end because I like Ja, but he referred to himself as a point god. Point god? And it's not that wise when you haven't dribbled one dribble in that league to say that.
I do agree.
And then you're gonna have to defend the Westbrooks and defend the Stephs and defend the Mike Conley Juniors for what it's worth. Mm-hmm. And it's hard, man, because every night you go out there and somebody's wanting to. I can just go on
just
and on.
Just in the West.
Because they're going to want to torch you. Lonzo had to go through this, but it wasn't Lonzo's fault. It was his father's fault, right? And Lonzo can defend at a high level.
Yep.
So he started to figure it out very quickly. So now let's go back to Zion. Zion's everything Chris said. He's a dominating force without a dominating ego. And we haven't seen that in a long time. His teammates love him because he is unselfish to a fault.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's go to RJ. RJ averaged 18 shots a game. To Zion's 13 shots a game. Think about that. And in conference play, it was 19-12. So RJ Barrett is overrated to me. And I hate to say this for Knicks fans because he's a classic Knicks pick where you get overexcited about a guy who's a poor man's Carmelo Anthony. He's a high-volume shooter who doesn't make that many shots. He's a 31% three-point shooter, and he shoots a whole bunch of threes. And again, every time I saw Zion in a clutch situation, he made a clutch shot. Every time. He didn't get the ball that much, but the other guy only missed in clutch situations. We talked earlier about the three big games, Gonzaga and Maui, then North Carolina in the ACC tournament, then Michigan State in the NCAAs. Down the stretch, I don't want to go back into the gory detail, RJ just disappeared. He didn't disappear. No, that's not true. He just shot and missed and shot and missed in those games like crazy.
He made Duke disappear.
He wanted it. He just didn't deliver.
He just didn't deliver. And Zion would get one shot and make it. And it counted against North Carolina because it was the winning putback shot. But then down the stretch of that game, they foul RJ and send him to the free throw line to clinch it. It would have made it a three-point game. And he misses both of them. And he missed the free throw against Michigan State that would have tied the game, right? And in the game at Maui, he's trending all afternoon because he took four shots in the last 141 of that game and missed all four of them. Mm-hmm. And it's like, give Zion a chance because Zion, he'll cash, man.
Well, we got to play well, Skip, like I said, I'm not going to judge. Look, Coach K is a great coach. Who am I to question him? But for some reason, even though Zion kept coming up, RJ Barrett kept coming up empty at the end of the game, they kept putting the ball in
his hand.
They keep doing that for a reason, Chris Broussard. Mm-hmm. They're trying to tell you something, but you don't want to listen to them and hear it.
Well, maybe the Knicks should be listening. I don't know.
Well, he was getting ready to prepare the Knicks what he is. Yep. 18, 19 shots. He'll fit in perfect in the NBA.
Okay. Well, look, what the Knicks may have to, if they don't get KD and Kyrie or Kevin,
that
whoever,
changes everything.
Right.
Yeah.
Then they need to hope this kid becomes special and build around him.
Yep.
He's their future. If they don't get, Durant, that's what it's going to have to be.
Last point to your Giannis point, building the wall.
Yeah.
Can Zion knock down the wall?
You file him out.
Zion would be as predictable.
Okay,
as
that is
Giannis
true.
Was.
He's quicker than Giannis. He got a quicker first step than Giannis to me. Plus, as they say, light in the rear end. Giannis is a little light in the rear end. Oh, yeah. This kid is not.
You see them shoulders?
Hey.
The more ball, the
Giannis,
shoulders.
You know he's either coming down as a point guard or he's posting.
Yep.
Zion will be, that's the benefit of being off the ball. It won't be all on him to create his own shot.
He can Euro step. We can Euro step from half court and dunk it on you.
When you weigh 285 and you run into those mountain men in the length, you just knock them out of the way. He was knocking kids out of the way. Kids.
Them grown men at that next level, they grown men.
We'll see.
They pay, but
some grown men. Some grown men going to get dunked on.
This is a grown man body. He's got a grown man body already.
Hey, Skip, you do know the difference between college and NBA. They play for mortgages up here.
Okay.
There ain't no books for tuition and he did the training table. They play for mortgages. In private school tuition for kids.
Okay.
Get that nutrition.
We got to leave this one here, guys, because we got more coming up.
Veggie Pope.
Chris, okay, we hope you stick around with us. Stay for one more segment. Should LeBron give advice to Zion? That's what we'll discuss next.
Good question.